you are new to God's basement, trust the operator. He will guide you.
Thank you.
In other news, a car crash resulted in the death of a grandfather and an infant child. Authorities reported that the car swerved off the road and crashed into a tree. The only survivor was the grandmother of the infant child. Although she suffered major injuries, she is currently in stable condition. Authorities also reported that the grandfather was driving the vehicle and that alcohol might have been involved in the incident. I'm glad you made it through in one piece. Whatever you saw might have jogged your memory a bit, even though all of it occurred before you were born. Your parents, Neil and Sarah Young, had a son named Kevin. Your grandparents were looking after him when an unfortunate incident occurred. After losing their only son, your parents decided it would be best to create some distance between your grandmother. Although she tried her best to seek their forgiveness, the grief they felt was too painful. For a long time, they stayed out of contact with your grandmother. After a few years, they had you, James Young. They still were quite distant with your grandmother, possibly afraid the same incident might happen again. I don't want to bore you too much with those details. There is something I require from you. For you to unlock more of your memories, you need to go deeper into God's basement. To do that, you need to retrieve a security card to get past the door to your right. Fortunately, there is one down the hallway to your left. Just follow it all the way down, past the area with the red lights, and it should be in a storage room filled with shelves. Once you retrieve it, bring it back and slide it across the panel next to the door. I know you still have your suspicions, but I swear all your questions will be answered. Once you have a complete understanding of your past life, I'll tell you what God's basement really is, but you have quite some ways to go. Keep doing exactly as I say. And one last thing, good luck. Thank you.
In other news, a car crash resulted in the death of a grandfather and an infant child. Authorities reported that the car swerved off the road and crashed into a tree. The only survivor was the grandmother of the infant child. Although she suffered major injuries, she is currently in stable condition. Authorities also reported that the grandfather was driving the vehicle and that alcohol might have been involved in the incident.
James, it has been some time since I've last seen you around. By now, you should have some idea of the history between your grandmother and your parents. After the accident occurred, there was extreme tension between them. It was understandable given the context of the situation. Your parents wanted some space due to the grief they were experiencing. Your grandmother, dealing with the guilt and loneliness, longed for support and forgiveness, something your parents did not grant. I promise we'll get to your part of the story soon. To satisfy your curiosity for a bit, I'll tell you a small truth about God's basement. God's basement is a place to reflect on your past life. That statement might be a bit broad, but I'll tell you more as you continue your journey. As for this area, there seems to be a locked door with a keypad. I'm sure you'll figure it out. I'll see you around soon. Good luck. okay. That looked like it probably hurt. Good news is, this room looks relatively safe. I also have some more good news. You're going to be exploring your early childhood memories. For the most part, you were raised by your grandmother. A good chunk of your memories have manifested themselves in the form of journal entries. Read those carefully as they represent your thoughts and emotions at the time. You probably thought you'd be stuck in that dimly lit, creepy office area forever. At least you're getting a change of scenery. God, basement tends to manifest itself in an unusual way. The more you remember about your childhood, the creepier things can get. Remember when I asked you to ignore anything unusual? Well, that was just a joke. It's obviously there for a reason. In other news, last weekend, a brutal crime was committed in a quiet suburban neighborhood. The two victims were a young couple, recently turned parents, that were viciously stabbed while sleeping inside their bedroom. Authorities reported that the bodies were mutilated to the point of being unrecognizable. The two also left behind an infant son. Currently, there are no suspects or leads as to who committed the murder, but authorities are adamantly investigating the situation. Entry number 8. Recently, my grandmother has been acting strange. I've been waking up in the middle of the night hearing her crying. I usually find her pacing back and forth aimlessly. She usually won't even notice I'm there until I make my presence known. After she notices me, she gives me this blank expression, then walks away back into her bedroom. Sometimes I'll press my ear against her door, and I'll hear a distorted version of this classical song she always listened to. Although these incidents are rare, they still creep me out. It happens about once every few months. Hopefully she gets better.